Holy
shit. Holy god. Brewed in Brisbane.
That's awesome.
Brew dog. Then sour ale.
Are they all Aussie made? Yeah.
Ooh. Hi, Carl. Thanks, Richard. Curtis.
Hello. What are you doing?
How you going, guys? Curtis from Cutting Edge Engineering. Today's job is a 651 apron cylinder barrel. Customers brought it in with a lot of scratches on the inside. It had a pretty big failure. The apron barrel is used on the scraper for opening and closing the apron door. You can't actually see it, it will give you a general idea. So as you can see on the piston, it is full of scratches. That's from a foreign material getting around inside the barrel. Something's failed somewhere in the machine. It has transferred into the barrel and the piston. They're both completely destroyed. There's not much we can do with them, except for a rebarrel, and we're going to try and tidy up the piston. If we can't tidy it up, we're going to make a new one for the customer. As you can see on the inside of the barrel, there's actually 18 holes drilled into the barrel here. These barrels run a little bit differently to everything else. The oil doesn't come in through the head. The oil comes in through the collar that goes around the cylinder head. That's mainly because there's not enough room up inside the gooseneck of the machine where this lives. You'll also notice there is no weld on the head flange where the barrel is, because the barrel doesn't actually protrude the head flange at all. If you have a look down here, so this line here is actually the end of the barrel. Once we remove the head flange, you'll be able to see exactly how it all works. I'll explain a bit more about it then, but for now we're going to get it set up in the machine and start getting it apart. Righto, so we've got the barrel set up in the machine. We're holding on to one end with our four-jaw tailstock chuck. We've got the barrel in pretty good alignment there, running pretty true. We've now cut a steady bend, got our steady rest set up on that. So I'm going to first go in and take out this weld here to remove this end. Once that end's removed, we'll do a bit more swapping around and we'll go up and remove the weld to get the head flange off. So one of the ways we tell how deep we are inside one of the weld joints is we'll get a bit of oil smoke come back through. That's where the two pieces of material overlap each other. In this stage, we've got smoke a little bit early to where it should actually be. We've actually found a few pinholes in the weld, so that's a bit of a floor issue from the factory. This is a factory cylinder. No one's ever touched this one before. I can tell that by the submerged arc welds around both ends and also the build tag. This barrel was built in 09 of 1989. So we're 2021 now, that barrel's done a lot of work. So we're just going to keep machining into this and try and find the base of this weld. So we've done a little bit more machining, and this actually looks to be like there's flux trapped within the weld. That looks like, submerged arc flux. While we're going, we're actually going to remove a bit more of this material to clean up that surface when we go to weld it again. Worst case scenario, there's a flaw in the casting and it has actually come through the weld. So we'll keep chewing away at it and see what we find. Righto guys, so we've got our head flange off. We welded some zigzags inside the pipe to shrink that. We did have to apply a bit of heat to get the head flange to expand enough to get it off the barrel. Something I will point out, what's the go with all the holes around the barrel? The reason for the holes is it allows the oil in to return the cylinder back to its closed position. There's actually a big cavity that's been cast into the head flange, which allows the oil to travel around it, goes through the holes in the barrel to cycle the cylinder. This is not a conventional style, being the fact that the oil comes in from the side of the cylinder, not through the head. This is an actual head off this barrel. You'll notice there are no oil ports in it at all. These were designed to be in a confined space where there wasn't enough room to run a hydraulic line to the head, so they run it up through the head flange of the barrel. If you have a look down here, there is a lip that the barrel seats against, that lip there. When we put it in the honing machine and hone it, we need this surface to finish up level with the inside of the barrel. If we're to do it the way it is now, there's a good possibility there will be a misalignment, not from anything we've done. We can't 100% say whoever machined it when it was manufactured that that surface in there is true and concentric with this surface out here. So the easiest way to get around the problem, we're just gonna bore that out, we're gonna build it up, we'll then re-machine it to within a couple of mil. We'll fit that to the new barrel and we'll hone it all together. That way this face will end up identical inside the barrel. Righto guys, so we got our piece of material set up in the machine for the new barrel. This piece is a piece of 10¾ by 9 inch ID material. It's not what we needed for the job. We actually needed 10¼ by 9¼. It's currently unavailable at the moment. We generally will be lucky enough to get the right OD or the right ID. In this case, we didn't get either. So we've got a bit of machining to do. So we'll first off turn down the outside. We'll set up a steady rest, put the boring bar in, we'll bore out the inside, flip the tube and finish it off. That's how we do it with cutting edge engineering.
Hey. What? What you want?
That was a test run.
We weren't recording. Fucking rain. Is it bad?
Yeah. It's pretty loud.
You know what we're saying?
I don't know, do you?
I don't know, I'll just wing this. We'll put some footage in there, would we?
Yeah.
Put some footage in. It's full of scratches and it's fucked.
So imagine...
doing a 651 apron, cylinder barrel. So the... And we'll force the cylinder to... cylinder? Righto guys, so I'm just gonna do it again. You fucking dip me with it. Young guys, Curtis from Cutting It. Oh fuck. You've done that bit. Yep. I've lost it. Shit. Oh. This, fuck. It's not funny. No, fuck. Oh, fuck. Oh, fuck. I'm over it. Oh, fuck. Yeah. I'm gonna replace the whole fucking thing. I'm gonna replace the whole fucking lot of it. Oh, fucking pumpkin is sitting there. Missed a bit. Come back another one. Fuck's sake. What the shit? Here we go. What the fuck's up with these pants? That's about it.